Sean would get right in Taker's face and like literally looking up right in his face, because in Sean's mind, he literally believed, I can beat you. He literally believed that. So he never backed down. And somehow, some way, bro, even if he got beat, he gave him the fight of his life, and it went, you know, toe to toe. I don't feel that with Johnny Gargano.
Let's dive right into it, man. Let's shoot from the hip. Man, Vince Russo's boy, one of his favorite wrestlers. I know Mustafa Ali is his favorite.
Yes.
The Miz is his second favorite, and his first favorite is Johnny Gargano. So Johnny Gargano, we're going to talk about him for a second. You know, credit to EC3 and I, Johnny Gargano is a fellow Ohioan.
Yes.
Indeed. And so EC3, what was it like working? What was it like working with Johnny Gargano in the locker room?
Well, like, we've always had great rapport. We've been on the same indies together. You know, when I did that like hot little angle with Evolve, he was part of that. And then in NXT, we worked together a couple times. So being in the locker room, like, he's uniquely himself. I'll say that. He's very humble. He's very kind. He's a very nice guy. He has a quirky sense of humor. He is overall what I would gather a legitimate good human being. And, you know, now he's a proud father too. So
indeed.
He's a little introverted. I think that's what you're trying to get at.
Do you think that Vince McMahon, I'll ask you this question about how you feel about this too. But do you think that Vince McMahon had an issue with his size? I know he's a Triple H guy. I know Triple H really did a lot with him. Yeah. NXT, he's one of the like heart and soul of NXT during their time as a brand. He's one of the I guess Mount Rushmore of NXT. But as far as the main roster, it doesn't really, you know, it doesn't really correlate. It doesn't transition over to the main roster. Do you think Vince McMahon has an issue with Gargano's size?
Probably. And like, Vince has an issue with just about everything. Vince is Vince. Mm-hmm. He is a psychopathic billionaire, madman, genius, sitting on top of the throne of an empire and world he's created and will never let go of. He will outlive each and every one of us. He'll outlive cockroaches. He'll outlive the universe. He's Vincent Kennedy McMahon, gee damn it. And yeah, he probably has issues with the size in a sense. What benefited Johnny so much was, A, he had a great foil, like the NXT, the angles between him and Tommaso. The fans got to get to know them from the beginning as a tag team all the way through to like their epic confrontations throughout the course of that building phase of NXT. So that's how you get over. Yeah. People can emotionally invest in you, and they know who you are. They know what you're about. They feel your plight. They want to see you win, or they despise you because of what you've done to your best friend. And I think that's what works so well in NXT. Plus, they had carte blanche to have these amazing matches with a sustained amount of times to put, you know, I would almost say acts within their angle. They had a first act to a second to a third, and they concluded it. So they really had a great piece of business with NXT. Then you come to the main roster, that carte blanche and audience changes slightly. Your boss changes slightly. He doesn't know one thing those guys did. Maybe he watched them in an elevator going up and down in Titan Towers a couple times. Huh. All right, whatever. Like, so then, you know, presenting a very white meat, undersized baby face to a madman, he's probably going to have issues. And there's no breaking the mentality the man has. He probably is like, well, too small. Like, he's been saying that for 50 years about a lot of really talented people too. So yeah, he probably thought he was too small.
Along those lines, EC3, so we just recently had Tommaso Ciampa come back.
DC. Just a
super anticlimactic return against someone who hasn't won a television match the entire year, The Miz, as if that's going to help his stock. Why didn't they just save Tommaso Ciampa's return and just because Gargano's been off television for a little bit too? Why didn't they just reunite DIY?
That would take foresight and maybe some creative ingenuity, as opposed to just throwing things against the wall and seeing what sticks and having a creative process that's been broken for a very long time. That would have taken contemplation, thought, planning, and overall foresight into what can be done. So heaven forbid they do something like that.
And that's terrible too, because only a fraction of the audience, you know, because a third of the audience that we see on Raw, the third of average Raw audience watched NXT.
Right.
So two-thirds of the audience that is being introduced to DIY didn't see the two-year angle.
Yeah.
So why not reunite DIY and use that and recreate the angle between Ciampa and Gargano on a bigger stage?
Well, I'd say one thing is you can't repeat the past, and by no stretch of the imagination, what they've done, could that be replicated based on the new circumstances of being on that show with that man in charge? But what I would counter was, why not reunite them but reintroduce them? They've both been off TV for a while. Nobody was chomping at the bit, like, of the mainstream audience. Like, they kind of had, they've been around and gone, and they could have brought them together and created something brand new and unique based on the fact they have great chemistry together, that the history could maybe be revisited later down the line when the fans got to know them and their new personas. But that, again, would be a good idea. And we don't do that.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, you don't have to immediately go back to the feud, but they have so much good chemistry together that either you're going to just make them fodder to somebody, you know, to end this year, or to just some other Omos or something like that. You're either going to make them both fodder in some way, or you're going to try to maximize every single talent that you have. Like, you know, Vince Russo would talk about that a lot when he was talking about, like, for every person I see on the backstage, I'm going to use him or her in some capacity. And so, but that doesn't happen in WWE. You're just being used, and it's just match after match after match after match. You're not really building characters. And so if DIY came back, they had a pretty solid tag run, and then all of a sudden we see some tension, and they work so well together that I think that could be recreated on the main roster. Like you said, it does take foresight. It does take some planning, because this could be a year, 2 year, you know, run again. But it just seems like they're just throwing everything, you know, instead of really having foresight.
I think, too, what got them over in the NXT run originally was they weren't signed. They came in and had, like, great matches that, okay, we can't really redo this, but to reinvent them and bring them back, what if they came in as this, like, mismatched underdog tag team that wins? Oh, wow. And again and again. And then people are like, hey, these guys are winners. This is cool. Yeah. I haven't seen this. This is nice.
Yeah, pressure to make diamonds, man. It seems like the pressure isn't as much nowadays as it was before.
Everybody, they're just gears in the machine. And one of the things, I've talked about this a lot, but, like, I refused to say when I went back, but I immediately said it, was nothing matters. And again, all the great ideas. We've put more thought into Tommaso and Johnny G than their creative team has in this 20 minutes we've talked.
Yeah. Vince, do you think there's any hope to make Johnny Gargano relevant on the main roster?
Bro, I'm going to tell you this too, and I'm not BSing you. There were wrestlers that we put on boxes.
Oh, yeah, I've heard of that.
Yeah, right. So stand them on a milk crate. Bro, I'm not BSing. Stand them on a milk crate, bro. Literally, stand them on a milk crate. You have to do some. Bro, I'm not talking about the marks. I'm talking about the casual fans at home watching this show. Yeah. They're looking at this guy come out, and they're just like, come on, bro. Who is this guy going to be? That's your casual wrestling fan. I'm sorry. Listen, Sports, you can edit it out all you want. That's reality, bro. That's absolute real. I don't know Johnny Gargano. I hear he's a great father, a great husband, a great guy. That's not what we're talking about here. What I'm talking about here is he's not a believable wrestler based on size.
Here's the thing for wrestling fans, too. Vince is completely 100% accurate because a lot of times if I have see some wrestling or I always try to gather a civilian's response to something. If there's ever a chance to talk about wrestling, you'll look at it, and they say things just like that. And usually the women will say things. The women that are not wrestling fans that watch it are, like, ruthless, too. Like, why has he got this? Why is his hair so
white? My wife is like that.
Yes, well, I get that. My wife all the time. I always said, who are these guys?
Yeah. He's not cute.
Chris, I'm not just picking on Gargano. Those two new girls on Raw, Chase and who is it? Chantilly Lace, Chantilly and Chase. Who is it?
Caden Carter and
who are they going to beat? Like, bro, those girls are about 5'2". Like, who are they going to beat? Come on,
I think you're trying to capitalize on a. Casey Catanzaro or what's her name? Katana Chance now, I believe, because she was a American Ninja Warrior.
He can climb up the pole, dude. It's ridiculous. He's cool.
Yeah, yeah.
Probably won't beat anybody in a fight, though. Maybe she'll beat up Johnny Gargano.
There you go. Or maybe, Candice LeRae. You know what I mean? That's another one that's I don't know, man. I'm an old school guy, man. Look, my thing is, size doesn't really matter to me if your character is bigger than your size. You know what I mean? Like, I think someone can out character their size. Shawn Michaels was a smaller guy. He was a big character, so he looked bigger. Going against someone who's 7 foot tall, like Diesel and things like that, his character was bigger than his size.
Johnny's character is not bigger than his size.
No, it's not.
Yeah, bro, here's the one thing I used to love about Sean, because, bro, listen, I wrote for Sean in his prime. Here's the one thing about Sean that I loved. Nobody ever talks about these things. I remember, bro, writing a feud. You know, it was Taker and Sean. And if you go back, bro, and you look at the build to that, bro, Sean would get right in Taker's face and, like, literally looking up right in his face, because in Sean's mind, he literally believed, I can beat you. He literally believed that. So he never backed down. And somehow, some way, bro, even if he got beat, he gave him the fight of his life and it went, you know, toe to toe. I don't feel that with Johnny Gargano. I felt that with Shawn Michaels.
Yeah.
You got to pull that 100% right.
Indeed.